Hi, I'm Adam. I work with the Mississippi Watershed Management Organization. We're down here in the 34th Street Sand Flats in the Minneapolis River Gorge, and we're currently standing in a patch of garlic mustard. Garlic mustard is an invasive species that hails from Eurasia. And as you can see, it's one of the first things to really green up in the springtime, which gives it a distinct advantage over other species like native species. This helps it gather more nutrients, gather more plant mass at a time when other plants can't. Aside from that, it's a really prolific seeding plant. So one plant can create just hundreds of other seeds that can stay viable in the soil for up to 5 years or so. Community groups have been pulling garlic mustard down here for over 10 years from the Longfellow neighborhood, groups like Longfellow Community Council and Friends of the Mississippi River. And it's something that needs continuous help from people in the community to keep it in check. It is a forageable plant. You can eat it. You don't need much of it though, and a lot of people like to make pesto out of it. So if you do that, just get a little bit of it and that'll go a long ways. So I'm going to try to pull one out of the ground here. And if you're not really sure about what you're pulling, one great indication of garlic mustard is that you can pick off a leaf and crush it up in your hand a little bit and then give it a smell, and it'll smell kind of garlicky, kind of mustardy, like that. When you actually pull it, it's best to try and reach down to the base of the root and really try to gently tug out the whole root structure. And this one's got a pretty big one. So as you can see, it's kind of got this large taproot at the base, and it's got a J shape to it. So you kind of can pull and give it a little twist, and that helps it come out a lot easier. Some of the main identification features of garlic mustard include this leaf that has like kind of rounded toothed edge on the edge. Another thing is that there are purple parts to the twigs on the leaves themselves, or the stems of the leaves, and they also have little hairs on them.
Hi, I'm Alicia Beatty. I'm with the MWMO, and right down here you can see the Virginia waterleaf. It's very small right now, but you can see it coming up through the leaves. And this is a native species, so it's exciting to find this in comparison to the garlic mustard that we saw pretty nearby. This tends to live along riverbanks, moist areas, woodland areas. And you can see on the leaves that it has a few little white spots, and that sort of looks like a water stain, hence the name waterleaf. And typically what we see is when there are a lot of invasive species in the woods, like garlic mustard or even buckthorn, that native species like this one tend to get outcompeted. So it's great to see this here, and we want to make sure that we can see more of these in the woodlands as we walk along.